superintendent search process, and Ken is here to do that. And Ken, before you get started, just want to let you know that we, everyone has your presentation, and we're meeting, you know, we go, or your paperwork. I did, I don't know, a week or so ago, sign the contract with the school exec connect, just wanted the board members to be aware of that, so we're moving full steam ahead. Obviously, the board is going to be very intimately involved in this process, as well as some other stakeholder groups, but we do have the administration, who I wanted to have here, to understand what this planning process is and get their input on it, for us, if we have decisions we need to make. As well as, Jeff is going to be at this one, he probably won't be at future meetings, but he knows, from a perspective of being a candidate, as well as more importantly, everything going out of the school, what our timelines might need to look like here. So he'll be here for this one as well. Alright?
Okay, well, first of all, pleasure to be back here. I've watched your school closing today, first your 2 hours, and then you close. Okay, are they going to have a board meeting? And like good board members, you always show up, so we're here, this is great. But we're really excited to be working with Byron and the process. Our goal tonight is to get all the details put together relative to the search, so that everybody understands, what we're going to do, what the timelines are going to do, and what the process will be, so that you can, give that to your public and everybody knows exactly what's happening. So, because, you know, this is your search, and so, you know, we're going to give you some guidelines, but you know, if you want to think differently or do it differently, or timeframes and so on, certainly that's your decision to make. And I guess we have three new board members there, so congratulations to you. It's going to be exciting to get to be part of this process and move forward. So, I gave you the agenda, and what we want to do, we've got a suggested letter to go out to district stakeholders. We want to talk a little bit about how we're going to get, engaged, the community and the district staff through your focus groups and so on. We're going to do a search calendar to make that all correct. And then what groups we want to have, what kind of advertising, what kind of compensation guidelines. You don't have to have exact dollar amount compensation, we just need to know some general areas. And typically what we do on that is just take the current contract and take a look at that, and then we post everything regionally competitive and you can go from there as you negotiate the contract. So if you look at the document that would go out, typically we would put this out to, you would put this out, basically an email or on your website, and then typically don't send it out to everybody, but it's up to you if you want to do that. The first paragraph, basically, after the intro, just says that Bob and I will be meeting at a certain date that we'll determine tonight to meet with board members, school district staff, parents, students, community members, individually in focus groups. And what we want to know, basically, and you have that document behind here, we want to get as much information as we can about the about this community. We want to know what the strengths are of your district. We want to know what your challenges are. We want to know the goals. What are you looking to do over the next 3 to 5 years? And then most importantly, we want to know what kind of characteristics and skills you're looking for in superintendent. Because what we strongly believe, as we said last time we were here, this is about a match. And so how do we find the right person to come here and do what you want to do and not do what they want to do, in a sense, okay? So we would gather that input, and we're going to gather that input in two ways. One, I just talked about the focus groups and individual interviews. The second one is that we provide an online survey through SurveyMonkey, and the survey is exactly the same questions that you see on the superintendent profile document that you have. We do, because it's a SurveyMonkey form, we give a bunch of suggested ideas and then an open-ended, so you can either pick from some choices or you can add whatever you want in there. So each one of the questions has an opportunity to add what you care to do. And typically then we would create that document, we would give that to whoever you have in your district around your website, and then we'll just give them a link, they can just pop it right in there. So it's very simple to do from a district standpoint, it's just a matter of linking it to your website. So anybody going on your website can just punch on that and go right to the survey.
So you guys create SurveyMonkey, yeah, your instance of SurveyMonkey, and then you give us a link,
yes.
We put that on the website, and it's driven through your...
Yeah, instance. And so it will come on your website, then it will go to our SurveyMonkey, you know, form. site.
Great.
And then when we come back, we'll give you all the information that comes out of that.
Sure.
So that says we're coming here. The next paragraph basically gives you the times and dates that we're gonna put in tonight. And then again, how you do the, where you go to and how long you have to access that document. And again, our phone numbers are there, so either one of you, people can call if you want to, and actually have had a couple of calls in the afternoon. We haven't, so we've got people out there who are interested, so anyway. And then it's signed by Odyssey Court, either one who sends it out, okay? So what I would first like to do is if you go to where it says gathering feedback from staff and community, it's right after the form. Like I said, we typically do three types of input. One, individual. Second is the focus groups, and then third is an open meeting, open to anybody, staff, community members, or whatever. And typically what we do is individual interviews. We try to set up individual interviews with each board member. Because we really do want to, you know, we'd like to get your personal feelings on all of these five questions. Some boards have chosen to do it together, and so you have an option. It's one of your first choices tonight. You know, do you want to do individual interviews or do you want to do it as a board? And if you do it as a board, obviously you got to post it because it's me. You know, but typically, I would say 90% of boards do individual.
Mm-hmm. Thoughts from the board?
I personally feel like people will be a little more open if it's a one-on-two situation,
yeah,
right, or a one-on-one situation.
Yeah.
But that's my personal opinion. I would be open to either. I'm pretty transparent myself.
And my only concern is new board members, if able to, comfortable, seated, that be able to do individual ideas. I think.
Okay. So we'll do individual interviews with the board. Okay.
I think so.
And then one other individual interview, if you care to do that. A lot of the districts have an individual interview with the union association, whatever you call it, teachers organization president, to get, because they're the largest employee group in your district.
Mm-hmm.
That's up to you. You know, we can, if we don't do an individual interview, obviously we're gonna do a teacher focus group of representatives of that. So you can include that in that, or you can do an individual one.
I would be in favor to having a BA representative, president, or whoever they be, is their representative. Does anybody have any comments?
I agree. It's a different perspective.
Okay. And just another individual interview with that person. Is that what you're saying?
I think there's two co-presidents.
Okay, so then
right,
co-presidents.
Yes.
Yeah, we'll do the co-presidents.
Was
okay,
that
correct?
Brooke Woodhouse and Allison Newman are the co-presidents.
Devin, you're keeping notes on the names and email addresses we need to get to. Okay.
I think I will be working very closely with, as we, determine a date and a time to schedule, because obviously you're going to have to schedule that here.
Definitely.
Okay, so we'll do that. So we'll basically have the eight individual interviews. Okay, and that'll be, interviews are about 45 minutes. Okay, and so we'll set it up with you on the day that we're here. Bob and I will both be here so we can double up.
Sounds good. I have one question though.
Yep.
We have administrators here, and I was thinking the administrators would be a single focus group.
Yep.
Is that what you all were thinking, or are you thinking personal interviews one on one would be better?
Together.
Okay. Thank you. I just wanted to make sure that.
Would that include Janine Eady, the director of special education?
I don't know why it would not, because
okay,
she's considered administration.
Okay.
Yes.
So if you go down the next group, then that's what we're on the focus groups. So one of the focus groups will be the administrators, okay? Another focus group would be our certified staff. And typically, we leave it up to the teachers if they want to have representative samples, or we can probably handle 20 to 25. Any more than that, you don't get a chance to say it. We say 15 to 20 at the most. Usually it's 10 to 15. You want people who are there to have a chance to have say something like this and not
We can almost do three from each building.
Yeah, do some, yeah, representative each building.
The BEA has an executive council, and that consists of faculty reps from all buildings, so that was the easiest tool to use, and because they do represent them on a number of other issues in the district, so that would be one option.
I would look to the administration if they, for thoughts on whether or not they thought, they feel that's a good representative team from their schools, or would site-based teams be better?
Either way, it probably works. I mean, I would hope that the executive committee would have maybe some surveys and get other ideas as well, and to try to get a representative sample of ideas.
Okay, and not that the rest of the district won't get the survey anyway, so they can still really provide their opinions, just, it's just not as back and forth really.
You have two ways that they can provide their opinion if they don't end up in that small group. We invite anybody to the community meeting, so a lot of our community meetings have a lot of staff and a lot of community members, you know, people who weren't in there, or anybody can go on the online. So we encourage all the staff members to go online and do it, you know, and so you get your input directly into that.
Right, and on, the online survey is anonymous?
Anonymous.
Okay.
It's anonymous, and only one email address can do, you know, once you access, you can't access it multiple times.
Ah, okay, gotcha, thank you.
So how does that work if you have one email address for two people in the house?
Then you better get along together.
Sit together and fill it out.
I don't know, you go find somebody else's email address, and go for it. No, we do that only because you don't want someone, you know, going on 100 times and then changing the perception thing, so.
So then for Deb, I unless the board opposes, I would think the executive council, you said, of the BEA would be another focus group.
Okay.
Or we can let them decide how they are, do it too.
Typically, we just say union co-presidents, or in this case, co-presidents, pick your group, you know. You don't need to get, I mean, it doesn't make any difference to you, really. That's their
Right.
However they want to do it, it's fine.
So.
We'll have a group of certified staff, so however that comes up. Okay, then I don't know what you call them, every district is different. Some call them classified, some call them support staff, some whatever, but this was to be typical, your other, anybody,
paraprofessional.
Transportation's one, custodians.
Yep,
secretaries. Other parapros, if you have that group. All the other people who are not certified would be in the NAC, this group, representatives from those groups.
Well, this district has bus drivers, clerical, custodians, paraprofessionals.
Yep.
Our food service is actually contracted,
okay.
So they're not.
Okay, so those four groups.
Those four groups.
You know, give us a couple of representatives from each one.
So, Jeff, do you think you can work with the administration and determine who these individuals are?
Sure, yep.
I know Jen, you know, I don't know if you want to talk to, who is it at the bus bar again?
Val.
Yeah, so if you want to talk to Val, or if you might want to just pick someone as well.
Sure.
Jennifer, right. However you guys want to do it, I think you have a better thought than us, than we would.
Right.
Is Jen part of that group then too, Jen?
Jen will be part of the
administration.
Yes.
And again, 10 to 15 people, you said?
Yeah, you can have whatever. We if you got four groups, you know, two to three people per group is fine.
Right.
You know,
I think we just have to be cognizant of schedules.
Yeah.
Right? How are we going to get those people together?
It gets difficult to get everybody together, so we try to get a representative sample. And we'll go from there.
Okay, thank you.
Then the fourth focus group is high school students. We like to meet with, whatever, 10 to 15 of them. And a representative sample, so we typically don't like to say, well, just give us the student council, or give us the, you know, we ask the high school principal, just, you know, pick a group and arrange it. We just want to get their input, and actually, and you'll find, and they're very insightful. It's amazing.
They are.
They see it from another lens, you know, and so, so we'll.
So Steve?
So pick.
You got
a group. Different grades. As well.
Yeah.
And then, I don't know, do you have a kind of a parent council for your different buildings, or some districts have, you know, like a PTO or parent leader from each building, and they meet on a regular basis, but if not, do you have any other parent organization that you want us to meet with that's kind of organized or not?
They would go on the community, they only.
If you don't have one, don't create.
PTO would be probably the, we do have a world's best workforce group of parents as well.
Okay.
But maybe the PTO would be the best avenue to get a specific parent group.
Did we have the PTO last time?
I'm just curious.
And then.
I can't remember.
No, we did not.
Kind of what you're saying is perhaps separating community as well, because what I'm thinking too is maybe some membership from the Byron Chamber of Commerce.
We could do that too. If you have, would there be 5 to 10 people in that Chamber of Commerce one?
Maybe the Chamber of Commerce in the city, in the city.
Let's do that one as a group, a Chamber of Commerce group, we'll add that one.
Chamber, township.
And that would be the frequency. And then we'll.
So why don't you and I sit down and create that list?
A PTO kind of, do you have a parent organization in each of your schools?
We do, well, not each of the schools, one total.
We have one PTO group, and the principals actually have most contact with the PTO, so.
Representative from each.
Yeah, you have a representative, okay, so just a representative group for that, and we'll put that as a PTO group.
Yep, so Deb, you'll need to get those names from the administrators.
Just mark them each one.
Yeah.
So what we end up with then, as I'll review it, we've got administrative group, we've got a certified staff, a support staff, classified staff, whatever you call that. What do you call it here, so I get it right? You call them support staff, you call them classified?
Support staff, support staff, yep.
Let's just call it that.
There you go.
So we have that, then we have high school students as four, we have a Chamber of Commerce 5, and we have a PTO group as 6.
Six, yep.
Six focus groups.
Six focus groups.
Okay, then we do an open meeting, and we typically do it in the evening at some time, could be 6, could be 7, some have done it at 5, it's kind of your, and that's just open to anybody. So we've had, we did Rochester, I think we had 300, but they were in kind of a turmoil at that point.
Yeah, there is some issues.
And we just finished one in the upriver and we had 0, so, I mean, you never know, okay. We typically, you don't get a huge amount, but it's an opportunity for people who want to come and move. And we usually get a number of people very interested and want to be there, so, you know, if it's a smaller group, they're there and they want to get their point of view in, so. Do you have a time that's best or that you normally do things?
I believe our town halls are at 6 o'clock, Jeff? Maybe at 7, some.
Township meetings?
No, I'm talking about a town hall meetings, you know, like when we have one.
Town halls are typically at 6:30 or 7.
Okay.
Pick a time, it's, it makes a difference.
6:30.
6:30, okay. And that will follow the same, it'll follow the same sequence we do the focus groups. We'll ask them the same questions and get their feedback, and we incorporate that in, into the document. And I should have talked a little bit about that. The document that we will provide, and after all we get all this information, we'll put together all the feedback from all these different groups anonymously. And so it'll be, for example, it'll be board, and it'll be all the stuff that you all say in together. And we'll give that document to you, and it's really a nice snapshot in time what your district's thinking, what people are thinking about all of these, where you are, what your strengths are, what your weaknesses are, where you want to go, you know, and it's all part of that process. And then we'll present that to you at some point, and we'll talk about that as the timeframe goes on. So just for Deb's review, we've got 8 individual interviews, we've got 6 focus groups, and we've got 1 community meeting, okay?
And one of the individual interviews is 2 people, the BA.
Yeah, and there'll be a co-president, yeah, right, yep. So what we typically do then, you know, Deb and you and I can talk about this, but basically you can double book us in that for Bob and I that day, so. And if some board member, for some reason, whatever day we chose, and can't be there, we can do a phone interview for you. I mean, we do that all the time. So if somehow, you know, your business or situation, or you can't make it or whatever, we'll get your input. We'll just call you on the phone. That's all.
And each one of those interviews are how long? I know the open meeting, you say 45 minutes.
You know, the board individual interviews, you know, however long it takes. Usually it's half hour, 45 minutes, something there. Depends how much you want to talk. So,
all right, so I would tell the board you have 45 minutes available?
Yeah, 45 minutes available and you should be fine.
Okay, thank you.
During that day. Okay. And we can start, you know, we can start early, so, you know, you can to get us in so we can do it, and we're down there. Okay, so that's the focus group thing. Now, the next thing we want to talk about is the schedule. We did order that search calendar that's been open and vacant at this point. We are meeting tonight. The stakeholder letter, once we fill in the doc, you know, the little blanks, we would say send it out, you know, it's Tuesday, by the end of the week, you know, however you want to do, send it out tomorrow if you want it, but that's up to you, but whenever you want to send it out, the sooner you get it out, then people know.
And do you recommend that goes out from the school board?
Yeah, from the school board, yeah.
Okay, right, that's what I thought.
Yeah, it'll be signed by you, or, you know, the names will be on there.
Names there, right.
Yeah, not signed necessarily, but, yeah, go from me, out to the community. And then I would post that, you know, the calendar on your website, so anybody going to the website can either just post a letter, some districts just post a letter, because it has all the dates, and some just pull out the dates and put it on, whatever you want to do is fine. Just so people know what's going on. Yes?
With posting it on our webpage, do you think we should have one tab that would have, that they can go?
Superintendent search under the district, maybe under the school board? Don't we have over on the left, the school board page has school board members, meetings, all of that, maybe add another?
They could even create a front page tab if you want to without going to the school.
Right, oh, that would work, that would be better, I just don't want it to be a lot of work.
Yeah, I think you might want a tab, we call it superintendent search process or whatever you want to call it, just so anybody coming in can quickly access it without trying to find it tomorrow.
It might be very far for it.
Good idea, Harvey, thank you.
Okay, and then we'll try to get the internet feedback, Survey Monkey, put together by this weekend, so it'll be up and going by Monday, and we can get it to your, wherever the person is, and I can work through Deb on that, whoever you want me to send it to. Okay, we are suggesting that either January 25th or 26th be that. We like to do it as quick as possible, so we get going on that. And I don't know if either one of those are a better date, or either one of them is a good date, or what, but.
Administrators, if you're gonna be part of this, just as you know, every Wednesday morning we have our admin meetings, and we could reserve a portion of that time if you want to be here Wednesday morning, after the 25th, to do that. That would be good, because they're all, they've all planned to be there anyway.
As a time, right, yeah.
And that day works for me as well, because I actually have some time off that day.
Works for me.
All right, 25th?
25th?
All right, we locked it in, okay. And then, when we get all this information.
The 25th was for the individual interviews.
Yeah, the individual interviews and the focus groups will all be done that day.
Oh.
Everything will be done in one day. Now, we're gonna be here so that you know.
Right, yeah.
We'll be here all the way through the evening, so if you have to work, we can meet you after work at 5 o'clock or whatever.
You thinking the focus groups that same day?
Yes, we will.
Oh, I was gonna say, that's no.
I don't know if that's enough notice.
In a week, yeah.
It would be a push, I would assume, yeah. First we have to reach out and see if they accept, and then give them.
But most of them are employees of the district, right, for the focus groups.
The only ones you have to reach out would be the chamber and the PTO.
The chamber, right, because of community, yeah.
The community part's the one that I would struggle to say that we could set up in a week and have them come in.
So could we do all of the focus groups except for the community one? Finals for students. So the student and the.
You know, if you want to push it into the following week, that's fine, I don't, it's up to, you know, it's really, you could push it to the first, which is a week later, if you want to.
I think.
It's more up to you, I mean, you're the ones who have to set it up.
But for those two groups?
Yeah.
Okay, so for the student group and the city chamber group, we would push to the following week?
If we could, just keep us from driving down here twice for a couple of meetings.
Oh, okay, all right, gotcha. So you don't want, so we're scratching the 25th, and we're thinking the weekend?
Yeah.
Gotcha.
And so if you want it, if 25th isn't going to work, or 26th, let's push it back a week and go back to the first thing. That makes sense? All right, we're gonna make that February 1.
There's gonna be some of us that are gone on the first to the Minnesota Elementary the School Principals Association convention. I know you're gone, I'm gone, Amy's gone.
February 1st, for that whole week?
Wednesday, Thursday, and then coming back Friday.
So you could do Monday or Tuesday?
Yes.
Okay.
31st is fine too, whatever works, Monday or Tuesday, the one.
Tuesdays are better for me.
Tuesday would be better.
So the 31st?
January 31st, alright.
Okay.
Four.
What?
Yeah. Well, see, just that kids are in the school day, absolutely.
Because otherwise you're gonna start talking about.
It's important for them, this is part of their learning, so we'll take them during school.
Typically what we do with the students, we do it over lunch hour.
Yeah.
And if you can feed a few of them out of there.
Right.
They all like food, so they're fine.
We'll figure it out.
We got a spot for it.
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll figure it out.
Alright.
First thing, through to the 31st.
Okay, we'll do January 31, okay. And then, to go back to the survey.
Can I stop you for one second though?
Yep.
Going back to those focus groups on the 31st, since we're gonna be having students at the high school, do we wanna try to have this in the high school? That room, that used to be the, yeah, the NPR, used to be the district room? Is that where we wanna do the focus groups?
That's up to Steve, I don't know how much it's utilized during the student day, but if we just reserve it for the day.
It is, but we can adjust and adapt.
Question?
We can also put it in, we can also put it in the old staff room, we don't have really super nice chairs yet.
The recommendation I would make is that that room can get really noisy during the student day particularly. And I would say we probably have to look at two sites. If you're gonna have adult groups, I would say the best place is probably in this space right here to meet with them. And then to move to the high school for just the student.
Bob and I agree the one, I mean, you know, if you have it in two sites, it's no problem.
I just didn't want them to have to travel back and forth and lose time. Okay, that sounds good, we'll figure out, we'll assume location here except for the high school students.
Okay, then, when we post the survey monthly, typically, if you're gonna do focus groups on 31st, I would say that basically by the first or second, we ought to have that completed. That gives about, well, 10 to 12 days for them to go online. So if we say February 2nd, which should be a Thursday, for the online, be done.
So they would have from January 21st or anytime?
Yes, until February 2nd.
To February 2nd.
Yeah, and then what we wanna do is to put this together in a document for you, and I just heard you had a board workshop on the 6th.
February 6th.
So if that works, one of us would come down, we don't need both of us come down for that, one of us would come down and give the information and then.
So.
And answer any questions.
Is this where you present the profile?
Yeah, on the profile, so.
Including the survey and all your focus groups and.
That'd be February 6th.
Correct?
Yes.
It would be the complete presentation?
Yeah, yeah, correct. Yeah, we'll have all the focus group information from the 31st, you know, and all that, so we will put that together that week. And then the online survey, you know, you pretty much punch out the data on that pretty easily, because it's a sophisticated survey, it isn't, we don't have to write everything down like we do in a focus group, okay? So that should be fine. And you just give us a time. If you are doing a, what do you say, then 5:30 on that day?
The work session.
5:30 work session.
So if we put us on first, it's a little easier than to put us on for the end.
If you can make note of that for the February meeting, Jim. Thank you. Right after the consent agenda.
Okay. Then on, we'll start.
We're talking the February.
The work session.
Oh, there is no consent agenda, thank you, yes. Sorry.
So we'll start recruiting right away, and then we just have to determine how far, what kind of timeframe we have. And this is, there's a couple things here. We, typically a search runs from 8 to 12 weeks to get everybody a chance to do whatever they wanna do and get in and understand that. And we have to take their applications and we embed them and meet with them and all of that type of thing, so we. And then we will, the process will be then, we'll get all these, all the people who apply, we'll interview those that we think are reasonable. And then we will bring you on some night, afternoon, whatever, 4 to 6 candidates that we'll present to you. And it's, some of you are on the board, no, some of you may not, but in Minnesota, it's a, It's not public information until the board accepts a slate. So we're gonna bring you a whole bunch of stuff about these people, but we can't identify them by name, by law. And so then once you say, okay, I got enough information, usually boards trust the consultants, but we'll give you those. And as soon as you approve the slate, then the names are out there. Okay, and so what we try to do then is to try to do that first round of interviews, like, right away, basically. First round of interviews immediately after you select the slate. So for example, if you do a slate on, you know, one night, we would like to do the interviews within the next couple of days. And boards do it two different ways. Some do it all in one day. And so we do like two or three in the morning, two or three in the afternoon, or two or three late in the afternoon, two or three at night, you know, however your schedules are. Other board members like to do two evenings. So there's, you know, there's options to do, depending on how you want to do that. And then after that process is done, we'll take you through a process where you will narrow it down to two or three finalists. And the two or three finalists then will come back for all day interviews. And we try to do that relatively soon also. And the and then the all-day interviews, the only board obligation is, well, here's what we'll do. It started out, the candidate will start out with a tour of the district in the morning, and then we will have focus groups set up with the groups that we talked about for the focus groups. In other words, we'll have a candidate meet the administrative staff, the certified staff, the sports staff, PTO, and chamber, I guess we have five groups. They will meet them sometime during that day. Late afternoon. Then we typically run a community meeting late afternoon, 5 or roughly 5 o'clock typically, and then you have dinner and then you come back for the second round of interviews, your last interview, in other words, your second interview that evening. And what we do in that second, the reason we meet the different focus groups is that we want you to get the input from them and what they think about the candidate. So in each focus group, after it's done, we give them a form to fill out. How does this person meet the profile that we came up with? And then are there any questions or concerns that you may have that you want the board to know about? And you could put that on a sheet. We will have that sheet copied for you during the day. So when you come back, you'll come only to the community meeting. You don't sit in on the other focus groups. You want them to have their own, you know, without you being there, I guess. And then we'll get you all that information. The first round interviews are structured. We'll take it through and give you sample questions and all of that. The second round is whatever you want to ask. Each board member has, I want to know more about their technology background. I want to know more about their curriculum instruction background. Fine, whatever it may be, whatever is on your mind. You want to get to know them and you want to get your questions answered so you have that opportunity. First round of interviews are to narrow it down. Okay? And I really actually, we've never had a community involved in the first round, but we're certainly open to that.
They just brought out a really great.
Would it be
an open meeting, or would it, so it would be?
Yeah, it's gotta be, in Minnesota, all the processes have to be open, so.
So it would be.
But we invited people to come, there were certain people that we knew.
It was an actual group of about 15 people, that was that second group. It included administration and some community members, so it wasn't just an open thing.
What did you, how did that process go, you know, what did you do? Did you, the board interviewed them, and the 15 people sat and listened, or whatever?
I think they had a profile sheet, just like.
Yeah, right, we got a profile sheet.
They filled out a profile sheet after the first round and gave it to the board, and then I think that's how they, maybe I'm speaking for the board that was seated at the time, but I think they used some of that feedback along with their own feedback to narrow it down to three finalists.
Right, and then the board did, only the board did the three finalists, if I remember right, right? Or did the three finalists go to the community?
There was one group that was with the community, that included the students.
That's right, that's right.
And then the board.
So the second interview with the smaller group of community students.
So my recommendation would be, if you're going to err on who gets involved in the process, that the second round is more important than the first round. The second round, you want all the other groups, because you're narrowing it down to a selection of a superintendent, doesn't mean you can't do it first time, but don't narrow your groups the second time. You want the community, you want the staff, you want the administrative staff, you want the student staff input into the final selection of that.
The reason I like them on both ends of it is that, and I think a lot of people saw the change. First round of interviews went one way for some candidates, and having the public and the admin staff sitting in that, and all of a sudden we get to the final, we're down to two or three, things are a little more, you know, I don't like the word uptight, but there's a lot more writing on the line at that point in time, and you see changes, and to have other people say, do reaffirm that, you know, somebody presented themselves differently, you know, besides us sitting here, community members seeing something different, and to have them involved in that first part too, I think it's valuable.
The first round of interviews should be a structured interview of which every candidate gets the same question.
Yep, from us, but also they should have the community staff interview that same day, so for.
So you're gonna have, okay, this is very different than what we've done, but, you know, I'm open, okay. You're gonna have the community and staff interview those six people or four people or whatever it is, too.
Yep, same night, so they're gonna end up having a double.
Wouldn't they just observe those interviews?
No, because their questions are gonna be so different than ours.
Yes.
Okay, so what we typically done, we've not subjected all six to that process. We've subjected the finalists, the two or three, to the intense process, okay? Because that's the one, if you've got candidates that will, you don't feel meet your criteria, you know, for whatever, you're gonna narrow it down. You're gonna have, okay, let's take the administrative group. They interview the first round, they're gonna ask the same questions, they're gonna interview this person, and they're gonna interview them again. So they're gonna, basically they're saying you're gonna have the administration interview the candidates twice, like you are.
So I'm wondering if we could do the focus groups first, right? And then, and I'm not, I know that's a little different.
No, you can do it that way, if you wanna.
Focus groups first, right? And for the six candidates, let's call it six. And then, certainly the board does an interview, but then rather than have all the focus groups do it again, we could have representatives, one or two, from every one of the focus groups sit on one group together. And I think that's what we, isn't that,
well,
it was a smaller group,
everybody,
wasn't it?
Even that first one, I remember it was only a select, we had like one from the township, one PTO, one or two from admin. I don't think it was the entire group, like 40
people. Did you create a search committee from those focus groups? Is that what you did?
For the interview, I think we
it was a group of people, right?
Yeah, it wasn't everybody in every focus group. No, it was taken that we had.
It was about 12 people.
Yes, yeah, so we had a city representation, we had township representation, we have administration, yep.
We had students.
The only thing I would say is that's a 6-hour process, and you have to have community members that would be willing to give up 6 hours in addition to another day for the interview process, so.
It seems a lot.
Yeah, you gotta do the same for all six.
Yes. In my mind, as long as we have their input and their thoughts,
whether, not to discount the fact that the going through more interviews is a more stringent process, and the closer you get, personalities change, right? And you learn different things about the people who are there, people who are interviewing. So I guess in my mind it is, as long as we get their input, that's the important thing.
And the question you have to decide is if you want their input in the first round or not.
Right.
Okay. I would say, you know, I don't know, we've never been another board, and I've done 50 of these, where they have had a other group other than the board now. Okay. Every second round is intense with all the groups, have their input on the final ones that you choose. If you have input from a community group in the first round, in order to be fair, you've got to have the same people for all six interviews. Have to be there and have to give the same. Otherwise, you can get caught in an unfair labor thing here.
Invite them in on our first round of interviews, and they all can have a sheet. Can they fill out a sheet and give it to us?
You can do whatever you want into the board, but you better make sure that whoever those people are the same people. Because if someone doesn't get selected and they didn't have the same people interview them, that's not fair.
It'd be the same thing as if we used different questions.
That's right, absolutely.
They attend the open forum of the board, though, which has to be for the interview. If they were to
receive, it's all open, yeah.
Right, if they were to receive a profile sheet and were to give that to the board when they're done, they're not asking any of the questions, they're just providing some.
No, and I, right.
Yeah,
but
that's what I was, yeah.
Well, I just think if you have, okay, we have Canada today who has a nice time, and so 15 people show up and give input to the board. Candidate 6, who is at the end of the day and
right,
everybody's working, and two people show up
yeah, right,
and give input to the
right,
board.
Right.
That's not fair to the candidates.
Right.
Okay?
Right.
So if you want to have input that first round, I'm going to give you the legal advice here. You've got to have the same people all the way through. Just like, you know, as a board, four of you show up for one interview and six for the next interview. I mean, you know, it's not going to work. And you can be in big trouble. So I'm just trying to keep you out of trouble if someone becomes disgruntled and feels that they should have been brought forward.
Can I ask a question to Jennifer and Abe? Because and maybe I'm remembering a different interview process for a principal or somebody, but I thought I remember Jeff came in at the middle school and he did his presentation, and this wasn't board, this was the 15 people group. Okay.
Yes.
And the same questions were asked.
Yes.
We really couldn't expound on the questions or anything.
Correct.
Like that. It was, they answered the questions, they were done.
Yeah, so we had a list.
And then us
of,
as a group, we talked about
yes,
that.
Yes, we did.
We talked about what we liked, what we didn't like about that those individuals, and what where one person stood out and another person might not have, and kind of didn't really come to a consensus on a single individual, but it gave the facilitator something to take back and say, here were the comments on these six different people, right?
We met, we had let's say 12 people who had committed to being on that committee, and you know, they knew the time commitment, so they were there for the 5 or 6.
It was a long time.
Yeah, and it was, but these were people that were, you know, were interested in the process. And then Abe, were you on that?
Yeah.
And I think then we ranked for second and third. And then we gave those rankings to the school board, and then there was a discussion at that point of why we ranked those the way we did. And so that was the input that the board then had in to narrowing it down to the three finalists.
Okay,
three
so
finalists,
you guys then select the 12 or whatever that committed from admin, and that you
that was yeah, and that was there was a student, there was that was there was community membership, there was administration on that small group.
So all the feedback that you gave to the board is public information. Okay. So whatever you wrote to the board is available to any member in the public. Okay. You know that, right?
Right.
Okay.
Yep.
And it works, it obviously worked for you, you got Jeff, so you're fine. But the other thing that we typically do not want to talk about the negatives of the six candidates. We only like to talk about why you select these people. And if you have a general discussion about why you do not want this person, that person, and board members go off saying, well, I don't think Joe from wherever, you know, I didn't like his style, I didn't like this, all of this becomes public information. And you can have a search fall apart very quickly if they realize that the board is taking shots at all the different candidates. And if someone takes a shot at the candidate and you go ahead and take them, I mean, you got by it. I mean, but it is, you have a whole bunch of legal and kind of ethical issues as it relates to the candidates. Now, a perfect example of one was South Washington County. The board sat one night, argued about who the candidates were, for the finalists, and everybody took shots at the one they didn't like. All six candidates withdrew. And they had to have an interim for years. And they did all the papers, in the Twin City papers, about all of the bad things that everybody said about everybody. You know, why don't we like this person? Because they don't have this and this and this. We try to keep it at a very professional level. We try to keep it that you say, I want this person because he or she does this, versus I don't want this person because he or she is whatever. And I can't control that, obviously. No, I'm sure it isn't. I'm just saying, all it takes is one person.
Right.
And you don't control it. The farther you take it out of control. I am perfectly okay if you want to have a committee and they commit themselves to being there for all six interviews and they treat everybody exactly the same. All right? It's unusual, but you can take the input from them for the first round. You're going to have the same groups and are going to interview them. Here's what we do on those, the second day. We say to the candidate, give us 5 to 7 minutes of who we are, and then it's open questions. So if the administrators are interviewing, they could ask any question they want. Teachers are interviewing, they ask anything they want. There's no structured interview process for that second round. If you do the first round, you're going to have a structured interview process. You could get in trouble. So just let me know what you want, and what we would have to do then, in order to make the time thing work, we would have you interviewing one person, while another group is interviewing some other person.
Right.
We typically don't like to have people overlap because
it's professional. Jim, we could get a committed group like we did the last time?
I'm sure we could. I mean, it's totally up to the way you guys want to run this. But if that's the road you want to go down, there's no question that we could find people who have enough interest in the process to commit.
To commit to the both.
I would think so.
To listen and have them and then be willing to share.
And we didn't have any trouble last time, so.
I mean, I just personally evaluate. I mean, yes, I know we are the superintendent's boss, but we're here once a month and doing our part. You guys are here, you know, this is it.
Living the life.
Yes, you know, and for, I have a real hard time for me to, without having lots of input, to be able to say this is a perfect fit. I mean, I'm not here really, I'm not seeing how he's interacting, and it just.
It would be, I will just add this as a recent candidate in the search. It would be really awkward to see the same people at a different interview a week later. My recommendation, if you're going to just reverse the process and have the community groups up front, that you take their input after that, whatever, however they want to rank them, and through Ken's advice about how they do that, and then the last round would be just you as a board, interviewing the two or three, knowing what you know. That's the most recent process I just went through.
So if there were six candidates, this committee would interview the six candidates in whatever format is legally acceptable.
They can develop their own questions, but they've got to be the same ones that are legal. We'd like to look at them because they would ask us, you know, what's your family like?
Right.
Well,
yeah, we can't.
You know, kind of
so then we would get the feedback, but we would also get their ranking. And then, so that would be the first interview process. And then the second one, are we thinking, would be the board? I mean, certainly it would be an open meeting, right? But it would more or less be the board doing the interview at that point in time. And the presentation would happen then.
I
would we be interviewing during the, for the six candidates to?
Yes.
Yes.
Oh, yeah, right, right, you have to.
So it would be one of the groups?
It would be, you would have your interview, they would have their interview, and then.
So the first time the candidate would go through two interviews then, the community group, whoever is involved, and the board group?
The reason I bring that up is I wanted to, and again, I'm probably overspeaking, because this is all because I made the choice to leave the district, so I feel a little responsible for this.
Yeah.
I, when we have hired administrators in the district, and I'm gonna pick on our principal for a minute, the way the process has gone is, we have a large team of individuals that have been part, and they have had scripted questions, and they don't go off script, and that's just the way it goes.
Yeah.
And then what they have done is, they've sat down and deliberated and say, these are the top three or two candidates that we feel you should consider. And then they provided that to the superintendent, and then I made the decision with a board member present in a final interview, just to kind of vet the questions.
So I'll take this from the board standpoint, so you're gonna interview the candidate first round, and then you're gonna get feedback from this committee, who's gonna rank them.
Right.
If your ranking is different, so how is that gonna go? Are you gonna take their ranking and take the finalists from that group? Or are you, as a board, elected to pick the superintendent, are you making that decision? I, obviously you're making that decision, but the point is, the pressure from the outside group to reduce it down to the finalists can be pretty strong. And if everybody out there who is a community member and everybody else knows that these are the top three finalists, and you don't agree, now you've got a community split before you even get started.
I would just like to say that we agreed to hire this guy because of what he came with, the experience and the knowledge. And I know that lots of you have done this process recently, but we're spending quite a bit of money to have him help us through this, and I think we should trust him in that process that he's presenting to us, rather than trying to redo what another consultant did.
I'm new too. I maybe just put both boots in my mouth.
My question would be to you is, so you said you've done 50 already. The same process every time?
Yeah. Well, yeah, and the only difference has been is how many groups we met on the second day, because that varies the district and what they want to, what boards want to hear from. The first round is a, what we think is a narrowing down process. And if the board interviews this candidate with the same structure, same questions, and you get a feel. I mean, it is, and you're gonna get a pack of information from us that thick. You're gonna get letter of applications, you're gonna get, we have a application form ourselves for School Exec Connect, it's 5 to 8 pages, depends on what they write. You're gonna get all the letters references, you're gonna get all the transcripts, you're gonna get a cover letter, you know, you're gonna get 15 to 30 pages of information about each candidate. So you're not coming to the interview cold. I mean, you should have read through that, and we'll give it to you ahead, you know, ahead of time. So that you have a pretty good sense of who these people are. Now you're trying to figure out, is this, you know, what I read about from references, what I read about what they say, is this true? Is this the person I want to go? And so you're trying to narrow that down then to two or three finalists. Then, because it is whoever they choose, is going to be your superintendent, is going to have to interact with all these groups. We bring in all these groups for them to have, to meet with that candidate, ask the questions they want, know anything's legal. I mean, every group does their own questions. The sport group looks a little different than the teacher group, you know, in terms of what they ask. Then you get that feedback from all of those. Everybody who's in that group gets to have their individual feedback to you on what they think about these candidates. That you have all of that. And if we don't say you can rank or not rank, I guess you want to, but we don't care. You just, whatever you want to say. And then you will have another round of interviews, and you'll take all that information, plus your own contacts and readings and whatever, and try to, you know, end up with a guy like Jeff, you know, kind of thing. And that's what you're trying to do.
And at any point during the process, we have members of the public coming to us with their opinion and their thoughts.
They will.
From open meetings, I would assume that, and so that those influencers, they'll still have access, and they can meetings.
All the meetings are public.
Right.
All the interviews are public.
So it's just that they can't ask questions during that first.
During that time that you're interviewing the candidate.
Right, they can be in the room and listen to the person and definitely contact us and say, hey, if you hire this guy, I'm out of here.
No, and they can get,
Let's tell them.
That would mean that negative.
Yeah, you can do it, like I said, we'll make it work whenever you want to do it. I'm just trying to get, okay, what's a real respectful process for your candidates, number one. That's, our credo says take care of the board, but you also take care of the candidates. You want them to think good things about Byron. You don't want them to go away thinking, boy, what a schlock mess that was.
Right.
I'm glad I didn't get the job, and that happens. And,
I just add one other thing, Ken. I think, as I'm hearing it, what you're saying, obviously you've done this makes perfect sense, and I'm arriving personally just trying to go through all this. There's something to be said about the candidate, what you just said, because there's a fair chance of the six candidates that maybe come in, a couple of them might take another position before they even get to the two or three. And so you're going to spend all of this time, and the day after you spent all the time with the groups doing this, they may decide, look, this isn't a fit for me. And so I think the one thing I want the board to remember is that you employ one person, and that's the superintendent, and it's the most important decision that you make as a board, I feel. And for you to be able to vet those 4 to 6 candidates out that Ken and his firm have brought forward is really your decision. What you're doing then is you're saying, we're taking the best 2 or 3 and have at it. Now is your opportunity to ask the questions you want to ask, because inevitably there will be staff members that say, well, we didn't get to ask that question. And the way that Ken is offering, they get that opportunity.
Yeah, you get that opportunity. You can ask, we'll be in though. I mean, we're there all the time.
Right.
So we'll be in those interviews so someone can't say something illegal. But beyond that, whatever, what's on your mind? What do you think about teacher negotiations? I don't care. What's the hot button for you? Ask it. That's the point. And it's not structured. So you want to come to the meeting, you have, for example, if we do a focus, at the end of with the teacher group, it doesn't have to be just a console. I mean, you can be open to every teacher, even at 4 o'clock, anybody want to come. We've been in districts where 150 teachers are there. Obviously everybody can't get their say, but they can listen and they can give input to you from whatever they hear.
Go ahead and ask one more question, and then I think we need to come to a decision.
I was just gonna make a comment. In my humble opinion, I agree with what Jeff just said. So I think what's proposed is very appropriate. Based on exactly the way Jeff explained it very articulately well, I think it makes perfect sense from my perspective.
I would agree. I think that, I don't think there's anything wrong with the process we did previously with Jeff. And I don't think there's anything wrong with this process, but I think moving forward, this is the one in my mind that from a legal standpoint and from a timing standpoint and will provide us the best process while still allowing us to have the information we need from stakeholder groups that are important to us, because it is a very important position here. And it's not any one person's decision. It's a lot of people's decision. But a lot of people have to help us make that decision, because in the end, this board decides. So, enough said, that's my thought. Anyone else?
I've been confused since day one. Can you just give me the agenda that you would?
Yeah, okay. So the first round of interviews, it's a 1-hour interview. It's a structured interview, which means that we'll help you develop questions. We'll give you a bunch of samples. You pick ones you want. It's your questions.
That's the board.
And typically we do about 14 questions in that hour. So every board member, we just go around and you ask this question, you ask this question, go around, kind of thing. And we would say those questions would be in different areas. A finance question, an HR question, a curriculum question, whatever, those kind of things. But it'll be structured. So everyone coming in, you'll take notes on it, and what you want, we'll give you a document, you just fill in notes on each of the questions. At the end of that time frame, after all that, then you're gonna have to narrow it down to 2 or 3 finalists. And we typically do that, that the night after, the same night that your last interviews are. So if you do them all day, we do it at the end of the day. If you do it the second night, we do it the second night. Because you want to, these people want to know where they stand, number one, because they're out just like this. I mean, they're out there. Okay. And we want to lock them in to a second round of interviews before they go off somewhere else. Okay. So we try to keep that, once we start doing it, that tight, that frame pretty tight and time. Okay. So that's the first round. At the end of the first round, you'll narrow it down by your votes to two or three finalists.
There's no committee at that time.
Second round, each candidate, we say, has their own day. Okay. So a candidate comes in, he or she will set up, maybe start roughly 10 o'clock to do a tour of the district with the board chair, the outgoing superintendent, whoever you want. But you want to take them around and meet the staff, meet the people, go into the buildings, that kind of stuff. And then we usually start around noon, where we typically have the administrative group maybe over lunch with the candidate. And they can then, like I said, ask any questions they want. We'll have the feedback sheet. They'll turn that in to Deb, and then she'll make copies, and we'll keep through the day. But by the time the next one in the next groups, we'll go. And then at roughly 5 o'clock, you come in as board members, and we want you to sit in on a community meeting, because we want you to see how this person interacts with the public and with teachers and whoever comes. You know, how do they handle just questions off the cuff? Because that's what they are, whatever the public wants to say. And they'll also, who are there, give you the feedback too. You know, they look at a lot of sheet and do that. Then you'll have a break for dinner, and then you come back and do your second round of interviews with the board. And the second round of interviews, what we typically have done is just to go around and say, okay, Chris, you got the first question, ask anything you want. You know, if you want to talk, whatever you want to talk about, then it's hardly. And we just go around, you got an hour. You just keep going around until the hour's up, and everybody has their hour, and then you're done. And then at some point, you got to make a decision if one of these people are who you want to be your superintendent.
But isn't that the appropriate for the full board then, or is that
It's a final one. You're just going to have the one candidate. So.
Oh, that's right. Okay.
Three meals.
Two or three meals. Or you can have them here. You don't have to have anywhere. I mean, you can have wherever you want. You just got to feed them.
So it's one day for each of the candidates. Okay, gotcha. So
do you have a board member babysit them on that tour the whole day, or do we transition them from one person to the next?
Yeah, if on the tour you can have a board member, it'd be one or two. Or a lot of districts say, you know, the superintendent knows it as well as anybody, have the superintendent. You can decide that. I don't really, it doesn't make a difference to us. Whoever you want to take on the tour is fine. Whoever does the tour should be the same person. Right? So if Peggy decides to do it, she ought to do it all 3 days or 2 days or whatever it may be. Yeah.
So you're able to get us all the interview stuff before we actually have our 1 hour final interview with them?
Yes, you're going to get all input from all these different groups before you have your final interview. And where people, you know, board, how you can read through, people don't write theses, you know. They write two or three sentences about it. I mean, that, you know, whatever. I mean, it is, we've never, you know, and it will take time. If somehow you don't get through it, if it's scheduled for 7:30, the final interview, all right, we go to 8, you know, give you time to read them all, you know. And then we start the interview, and you got 1 hour. So we want you to get through them, and we'll make sure that you have time to. So you'll get everything. Now you have, I keep hearing presentation. Okay, so do you want, if you want them to present, and we don't typically do that, but some firms do, and it doesn't make it a better choice for superintendent, the presentations that we see, all day they're making presentations. They're talking to people all day, off the cuff, about a whole bunch of issues. Okay. A good some superintendents are very good at presenting and are lousy superintendents. Superintendency is being able to respond to a whole bunch of things from a variety of people. You're much more interested in how they handle that community meeting, how they handle questions that might be kind of tough, than you are having them give you a 10-minute presentation on personalized learning, in my mind. So we want you to get feedback, and we want that person will interact for 6 hours that day with people.
But I think we did. Everybody here agreed that we want them to do some type of short 10-minute presentation.
You can, if you want to, we'll
correct.
Hold that in the schedule.
Right, and I would respectfully agree with you.
That's fine.
If you like that
and want that, that's great.
Right.
They will do it. I mean, we'll just
right.
let them know.
But the reason why I say that is because with the past interview, there was clearly one of the presentations was something that was a deciding factor in my mind. Something in that, I'm not going to go into detail,
yeah.
but there was something during that presentation that I said, you know, that just doesn't sit well with me, right?
Yeah, no,
and
fine.
So...
Could you have gotten that same response from a question from that person?
Maybe, but the presentations we asked them to do were not the same for every person. We asked them to do something that they're passionate about that has to do with public
Yeah, so you have, so you will
so,
identify for us to tell them what you want them to talk about.
No, they decide what they want to talk about.
Well, you just said something they're passionate about,
which is
a defining.
Right, so we're setting, but I'm not giving them a topic.
No.
Yes.
No,
so
I mean,
we are doing
you
a
want them
bit of
to talk program. About something they've done in the district, you want to talk about something they're really passionate about. I mean, they want to know what you want them to talk about.
Right, and
there's
I feel like
stuff they could talk
if
about.
This is the second interview, yes,
that
it's
would
going
be
to be
fine.
An
That's
hour.
No problem. They can do the presentation first. And then you can do the interview.
Right. But getting back to Faye's point was, we're not going to have enough time to ask questions. And I feel like we've already had them go through we've already interviewed them for how long in this first process narrowing it down. So this is really the second time we're talking to these people.
Right, but this would be after they spend and we get sheets back from the people.
Right.
So taking their thoughts.
Yeah.
My other question was, if that whole day where they're doing their interviews,
mm-hmm.
and you said we get to watch them, how do we as a board?
No, you don't sit in. You don't sit in on those individuals. You don't sit in on the focus groups meetings, because what we want these other groups to do is have an honest discussion with them about whatever issues there are.
So, but you said we can sit on a community focus group
yes.
one?
Yes. In the community one, we want you there. We want
and
you to be
free
able to.
Form.
That's the open forum to anybody in the community who wants to come. Staff, community members, students, whatever. And we've had all kinds. I mean, we've had groups, large groups. And
would that be held at the auditorium?
Yeah, typically we do an auditorium.
Yeah.
But if you don't, we can do it up. You probably, I don't know how many you can get in here. You probably have large groups in there too. So that's your choice where you want
to
put it out.
Okay.
So we if I understand it right then, so the final round, they'll do a 10-minute presentation and we'll figure out the topic or whatever it is at some point. And then you can take a 5-minute break and then go into your hour interview. That's fine. Because it's an evening anyway. It's all theirs. It's, you know, it's their night. So whether they do, time is not a problem in a sense.
All right. Harvey, did you get your question
yep,
answered?
Yep, yep.
So things are clear in your head.
Yep.
All right. Any other questions on what the processes that Ken has laid out?
Okay, let me review it quickly so you know that. So all right, everybody. Got it. So we're going to have 4 to 6 structured interviews the first round. The second round, we're going to have all the feedback to you. Then their final interview will include a 10-minute presentation on some topic that we'll agree upon before we do that. And then you'll have your hour interview after that. That's it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Yep, that's fine. That'll work.
All right.
Okay.
So do we have a consensus on this being the process?
We're bringing to you the profile on the 6th of February. Typically, we would run roughly 8 weeks, you know, from the time we know what you're looking for, you know, at least. So if you do that, that runs you into March, April. got, in April, you've got Easter in there, and you've got a spring break in there, right? Somewhere, Easter.
We have a Thursday, Friday, Monday around Easter.
What day is Easter?
Easter is the 16th, that's a Sunday.
Okay.
And then you've got, I think I looked at your schedule, 13, 14, and Monday off, right? Thursday, Friday, Monday.
That's correct.
So, the first round of interviews, the question is, do you want to do in a couple? Well, first of all, we have to come back and present the candidates, and that will be typically a 2 or 3 hour meeting, because we'll present all the candidates, and we'll set up all the, we'll define what the questions are going to be for the structured interview. We'll take care of all the details for the interview process, two together. So, we can do it right after Easter and do that week. We could meet on the, I'm just throwing out, so I don't know what you want to do, but if we were to present the candidate on the 18th.
Is there not another school district that is also looking for a superintendent very close to us? That's what I'm talking about. So I think the sooner we act and keep this.
So we can do it earlier, so it's just.
I would say, I think.
I don't like the big break.
Okay, so let's, well, here's another option.
Tomorrow.
Yeah, okay, here's another option. If you want to do a, okay, I'll give you another option. I'm going to speed it up. All right. So if we go into March, all right, and if you're willing to do, are you willing to do an all-day interviews? So let's, all right, let's just say that we do all-day interviews like on March 18th, that's a Saturday. So we would basically do, you know, 2 or 3 in the morning, 2 or 3 in the afternoon. Take a break at noon, and so they have, you have a little break in there. Okay, and then what we would do is present to you the candidates on the 17th, okay? Which would be, we could do it late afternoon, we could do it morning, whatever. It doesn't make any difference. We just need time with the board to present the candidates and give the information, okay?
Is there a reason that they're not speaking?
Is that a workshop? It's just a workshop, yeah, so we're good. Doesn't
matter.
So you're saying the 17th we would get the information on the candidates to review, and on the 18th is when we would start the interviews?
Yes.
Okay. Because you and your group already narrowed it down to 6?
Yes.
Okay.
Or less.
So make sure.
No more than 6.
Okay.
Okay.
All right.
So if we do it.
Question?
Well, just to read over 6 big files on one day.
Well, you can.
Be ready for the 18th.
Any chance to get them on the 16th?
Yeah, we can give them to whenever. I mean, it's if you want to do it on the 16th, the night of the 16th.
Works for me.
Yeah, that's just, is that just hand file over and we're done?
Well, you got it. Yeah, what we'll do in that is it's, we have to give you the files and talk about these people.
Yeah.
Okay, that we're bringing forward. And then you have to. It has to be a formal resolution, so it has to be a posted meeting to accept the slate, okay? All right. Then we will we'll give you all the questions ahead of time, but we'll finalize the questions and answer any questions you have about the process. And we will. And so when we leave there, everybody knows exactly what's going to happen in the 2 rounds, okay?
And that'll be a special board meeting because we'll be voting.
Yeah, you'll be voting. So it'll be a special meeting, right?
Okay.
So we'll
don't even have to meet.
Is after that meeting. So we'll give you, so you'll have all day Friday and then Saturday, whatever, You'll have a whole day or evening, a couple evenings and whatever to do that. So what time on the 16th do you typically would meet then?
On the 16th?
7th.
16th is a Thursday. Faith has a Zed meeting. They usually are pretty quick, and it starts at 6. Would you guys be okay with a 7 o'clock so she can still make that other meeting? 7 o'clock on the 16th.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
16.
And how much do we need to put aside?
An hour?
Yeah.
Okay.
If it goes a little longer, it goes a little longer. It's up to you.
I think somebody said 5.
Well,
if everybody's there at 5, I can change it for that day. That's fine. If it's an ongoing basis, it's rough, but I can change it.
do 5 o'clock then on the 16th.
Okay, 5 o'clock on the 16th, okay. Then on the 18th, I'll put a schedule out, but basically we'll start, typically start like 8:30, you know, 8:30, 9:30, 9:45 to 10:45, 11 to 12 would be like three, okay. So you would expect that you would start at 8:30 that morning on a Saturday. So we would have an 8:30, a 9:45, and 11 interviews, okay? And if we do three more in the afternoon, it'll be 1, 2:15, and 3:30, okay? And
make coffee.
And if we have less, we yeah, no, I'm going to give, Deb and I will work on it. We'll get the schedule. I'm going to give you a whole new one of these with all the right stuff in it, okay? And I'll get that to you tomorrow. So you have, yeah, you don't have to worry about writing all these things. Okay, so then what we would like to do then is to bring these people, because like you say, there's competition out there, we'd like to bring them back starting next week. And starting the 20th, 21st, and 22nd for those all-day interviews. Get them done, get them in, don't let them get a chance to think about doing it.
The 20th, we have a school board.
We have a school board meeting slated for 6 o'clock, but we can change that.
You can change it, yeah. And you, and it, like I said, it'll either be Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, or Monday or Tuesday. It depends on what you decide, how many finalists you want to bring in. So your responsibility
issues?
In those days is 5 o'clock. Okay.
On the
5 on. Five on from that. Right.
So evenings, the 20th, 21st.
Starting at 5 o'clock with a community meeting, that's your responsibility to be there from 5 on to whenever you get done with your interview. Okay.
Okay. That work for everybody?
Then we will, we'll do a real push to get the candidates and all this thing done in the time frame. But I do think there's some advantages, like you talked about. If you're competing, let's get it done and let's get somebody in. And I think that's a good move. Some boards are, you know, ruin a lot of time. So you know, this will work. Work for us. We'll get them in. You'll get a kind of 5 days or 6 days intensive training. You'll have your. And then we'll set up for that 21st and 22nd. We'll work with Deb yeah, down the road on that in terms of being able to schedule set up for the groups.
I'm just going to add one thing. If we were to reschedule our board meeting that month, we could schedule it for Monday, March 27th, which then would allow you a few days to name a finalist and negotiate a contract
if you wanted to
accept a contract on the 27th.
Yeah.
Make it happen.
That way we don't have to have we can just reschedule our March 20th to 27th, our regular board meeting, and you can hopefully then take action on
I just had a note on that. I'm coming back from a trip to the Dominican on the 27th, so I should be back by that time, but as I had that there's travel issues, I might not be here. Not to change your meeting for that reason, but there might be something might pop up where I won't make it back in time.
Can we do phone?
She has to be somewhere in the public place.
Are you asking about for her or just?
So, if she's driving back from the cities, then that's not a public place.
But I could stop somewhere.
But you'd have to post it in advance.
Oh, where you'll be. And I won't know.
But we'd have a quorum without her.
Yeah, if
she's already been
she agrees to the candidate, you got no problem. You know, she's really adamant opposed. And
if they're horrible, she can say, well, I wasn't there. I didn't
know. You're not up to
it. We're not going to get horrible.
Poor decision, yeah, right.
I just want to make sure it holds up any candidate that it's not a complete.
No.
Because his predecessor was. So that, I mean, that they wanted a full, the only way she accepted.
Oh, is it?
Oh,
is it
I don't, well,
yes.
Right.
So I don't want that.
I don't think, but the county's going to be, you know, they're not going to care if someone's traveling.
A 6-0
right,
vote is
the
same as a 7-0 vote.
Right.
Yeah, it's no different. I mean, they got the vote, you know. Right.
Okay.
And so, okay, so we have a schedule. amazing. It's like, my good work, good discussion. Appreciate all of it. All right. Now, the only other thing is, here's what we do on advertising, so you know. Obviously, MSC and MASA are the main ones that people go to in Minnesota. They're on our website. You can put it on your website that, you know, connect, you know, go on. Everybody applies on our site, so we have all applications. Do you want to go outside of those parameters? And I gave you a list. I don't think you need to, you know, but some boards decide they want to advertise wherever. But I think you're going to get all, people are going to know about it. This isn't, you know, if it's MASA and MSBA, people know about it. Plus.
So in my mind, really, if we were looking for more of outstate candidates, mm-hmm. we would go with education
yep,
or
yep,
administrators.
Right, yep.
In my mind.
Yes, that's okay. Exactly right.
And I'm not saying we want to do that, but I just want people to understand what this means.
Say that again, please. I'm sorry. Stop.
If we went with Education Week and American Association of School Administrators, those two figures down here, and put our candidate profile in there, that would be for candidates outside of Minnesota.
Okay.
If we wanted to further our stretch outside of Minnesota.
Do you think we need to?
No, I think, you know, the states around here, people are looking for jobs in Minnesota. They go to the MASA site or they go to the MSBA site. So we have a lot of candidates, you know, you're in Iowa, Wisconsin, if they grew up here or whatever, knew the area, they look on the Minnesota sites to
yeah.
see if there's jobs
not
in Minnesota.
Recommend
right,
MASA
yeah,
right? Unless
yeah.
it's, unless you're a Baltimore County or a Clark County, Nevada,
it's not
a
big
or
district,
district that's got 150,000 kids, they yeah. typically don't advertise on MASA.
All right, so.
Here comes the order.
Yeah, we don't go over the Mormons.
I think you will have, you know, you'll have good candidates from this whole area in Minnesota. And I think, you know, this is a, I said this before, but you've got a great little district here. I mean, and it's, there's a lot of neat things about it that you've done, and you got good people in place, and you've got facilities, and you got proximity to the metro, to Rochester. You're not, you know, this is not, you know, up in northern Minnesota, 110 miles from everywhere. Good. Yeah, you've done good things. So.
Yeah, so let's not do that.
Yeah, okay. Now, compensation guidelines, what I would like to get, and maybe have them just email me a copy of Jeff's current contract so that we have some sense of what's currently there. You do not have to determine this tonight, but we would like a range, you know, roughly a $10,000 to $15,000 range of what you would go for salaries so that. What we've found, we've never had anybody not sign a contract once you've selected. And the reason we believe that works is because we tell them what they're going to get. You know what I mean? In other words, we don't, I thought the salary was X and it isn't. Well, I wouldn't have taken that job. No, we want you up front to know here's roughly the range. Now you can vary a little, depends on what people do for fringe benefits. You know, there's flexibility in how you craft a contract. But if you're going to offer, I don't give a number because I don't know what even Jeff is making right now, so I won't put anybody on the spot. But the point is, you want to be realistic. You want to be in the ballpark with districts that are similar to you. And
when do you need to know this?
In a couple weeks. You know, we come back on the 6th.
When does the finance committee meet next? Could they look at this and determine what a range would be?
Sure. Yeah, we meet a week before the February board meeting.
That's fine. So next, that would be fine. That's well, we tell people now it's, you know, it's going to be regionally competitive, and then we'll get you figures.
Okay.
And Dick's contract.
Deb, do you want to send Jeff's contract to the whole finance committee as well as
the whole board?
Yeah. Oh, the whole board. Sorry.
Okay. Any other questions? Here's what I'm going to do, tonight or tomorrow morning. You will get a copy of this whole thing done correctly, okay, with all the right dates, and I'll check with Deb to make sure that we are on the same, you know, wavelength here. I'll send her a copy first, probably, and then, you know, if there's anything that we disagree on, then we'll talk, you know, okay? And then we'll go from there. And then you'll have that. And then the letter, you'll have all the information for the letter, then whoever puts that out for you in the district, put it out whenever you want. And like I said, and we'll get the Survey Monkey up by next Monday. So start on Monday doing that.
And Survey Monkey has the questions that we have in here.
Yes, yes, that's correct.
All right, so we did go over that. I would ask for board feedback on whether or not they feel like these questions are adequate, or would like to modify them at all. Please tell me you read them. Oh, yeah, right, yeah, but that letter's gonna go out from NEB, so if the board number's wrong, names are wrong, that's okay.
Yeah, no, these are all board members, and they're members, so.
So we'll.
I'll put the right names in, I'll send it to you too, for your new board members.
I'm fine with the question.
I think the questions are, they're general and give everybody an opportunity to say.
We just want a good sense of what's going on.
And these are on a Likert scale, or no, it's list, okay.
No, no, so they will, you'll get that, you know, 37% think that the greatest challenge to the district is financial or whatever, I mean, it'll all be percentages out of what people think. So you'll get a good sense of where the top ones are, where the least ones are. And you'll get all the comments that people make, and so the board will get that, so we'll make a copy of those for you too, so you can just read those. You'll have so much information.
Do you ever ask a preceding question to these on their kind of relationship with the school? They're a parent, they're a administrator, they're a teacher, they're a whatever, so we can slice that a little bit?
Yes, we do. It's there.
I'm sorry, I read this earlier today, I swear I did.
It's there. So when they come on the survey, it will ask them to identify themselves what area they are.
Gotcha, okay.
And, you know, you can do a couple, you could be a parent and staff member, but whatever, but that will be, and then you'll get the printout by those categories.
Right, exactly, okay. All right, so everybody's okay with those questions?
The survey is gonna go out when?
Monday.
Monday, can we get Dave to put something in the paper, Byron, do you forward it?
I think he is, but I'll send him a thing already.
And will Greta, will something, you put something in the TV as well?
I hope so.
Okay.
We were discussing how important this was last time, the TV had an article every day about your interview. Not you, but everybody's, it was so important.
Yeah, you better be honest, 'cause it's in the media, so.
All right.
Deb, will you put out an email to our staff about the survey information, or should that come from us?
I think this letter here goes to staff as well as.
Everybody, yeah.
So I think to do though is, well, we have to find all the community groups, we just don't have the city group, right?
Yeah, there's a.
The city chamber.
Yeah, I've written down some names of people for.
Okay, all right. So why don't the three of us, anybody else who, if you have some names that you want us to consider, why don't you send those to me? And then a couple of us will sit down, maybe the negotiations committee will sit down and go through those.
If you wanna adjourn, we can do it in 10 minutes or 30 seconds.
Okay, all right.
Done with me?
That's the only thing left, right?
Okay, we will, it will be a lot of contacts the next time, so. And you do have my number, and anybody, and if there's a question or your concern, call me, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can, I'll answer the phone, whatever.
Sounds great, so do we have a motion? Those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye, those opposed. All right, meeting adjourned. Yeah, let's go in there and talk real quick.
Yeah, I will.
That's my home. We can do it right here.
Yeah.
Okay, so here's my real comment, so here. I think you should have Mary Claire House. And then I think say one of the council members, Mary, you could have Mary Claire. I know, okay, so townships, there's a couple of options, and I actually paid you some cameras here. I think that'd be great. And then one township, I could have.
Oh, very comfortable, my little friend.
What's that? Well, Kelly told me she'd charge me double if I came over here. Anyway, so with that would mean we'd have six chamber members. We'd have two city, two townships.
What's that?
Doc Moulton?
Yeah, he has probably do all the.
Very open dialogue.
And I don't want you to be the.
Really.
So that would have two city, two townships, the six.
Yes, we will ask them.
We could then add, all of you could add a building where we could add a rep from Henry.
Getting information.
We would ask them, this for the six, that's what he said to me.
And it says it's fiction, but we have this.
There is a lot of them that.
So you give us a debt.
I mean, I think.
Because we have PTO separate. Okay, so now we combine those two into one now, so we're down to the back five. And I don't want him to think we're.
Here's the thing. Do you want me to reach out for them, or would you, would there be another person that you think would be better to go from board member?
Yes, we'll take your shot.
We didn't have that. If we had had that.
And then, if you got any other.
All right, so put some names there, put some names there.
All right, I know the scratch you can. I'll get this to Deb.
That's an email, right?
Okay, but in the situation.
And then put it on your website.
So then.
And then.
Mark Brennan, is he the chiropractor guy?
Monday. It's all done.
What is our date?
January 31st, right? No. Nope, their date is.
Is that why we're able to do this?
They're gonna do this interview on the day they are. Nope, it is, they need to be available.
I sit on a chair that's not there.
On the 20th, 21st, we have about a second.
All the answers.
The dynamic.
Oh, you know what? So this is, I'm sorry, this is just Tuesday, January 31st.
Right. All day.
That's why I presented.
Is he gonna be here all day?
And when you pull, because when you get to this second interview here, on the 21st and the second, it's.
Here's, very well. At 5 o'clock.
Yeah, and if, but if they can't, that's a big.
I will, I'm only a phone call away, so.
Was that? So why did you finish that list though?
I think we did.
Well, there's very, very top and the city.
All right, I guess I'm gonna talk to him, I wanna talk to Brenda. All right, you got Mary and, would you say we were seeing that?
Yeah.
It's that warm out.
And hopefully they all, we're taking this up here, if you want, you know, that was for.
All right, we'll talk more tomorrow.
Bye.
Well, that Byron, and we'll just say, I don't think how many ones did he all find.
We're all in the corner.
It's still on?